from the live music capital of the world, the Austin Music Network is proud to present the first annual Armadillo Homecoming Concert, taped live on Auditorium Shores on Sunday, September 4th, 1994, with Armadillo greats like New Riders of the Purple Sage, Tracy Nelson, Maria Muldaur, Marsha Ball, Omar and the Howlers, Commander Cody, and many more.
Too much fun. Too much fun.
It is time for Alvin.
Rock and roll!
Hello there. How y'all doing? It's going to turn into a nice evening here, I can tell. It's supposed to remind everybody, supper's ready over here in the tents, in the food tents, Threadgill's food tent. I want to remind you, don't try to drink your supper tonight. Go eat a little food over there. Then have a few beers, but don't just drink your supper. Go get a little solid food over there at the Threadgill's tent if you don't mind. Yeah, it's like I said, we're awful glad to be here tonight. Pour me a double shot. Pour it up, buddy. Pour me another to go. I had a date to meet my baby about an hour and a half ago. I fell asleep in my car out behind the bar, and I'm afraid she's gonna be mad. So pour me a double shot of whiskey so the hurting won't hurt so bad. Pour me a double shot. What do you say, buddy? Got my Chevy running right on time. I ain't been late to see my baby since 1969. Well, it's a long, long way to the liquor store, and I'm afraid she's gonna be mad. So pour me a double shot of whiskey so the hurting won't hurt so bad. I said pour me a double shot of whiskey so the hurting won't hurt so bad. Just to pour me a double shot of whiskey so the hurting won't hurt so bad. And it's a long, long way to the liquor store, and I'm afraid she's gonna be mad. So pour me a double shot of whiskey so the hurting won't hurt so bad. Buddy, look, my baby's already been here. She got tired of waiting for me, so she came down to have her a beer. And it's a long, long way to the liquor store, and I'm afraid she's gonna be mad. So pour me a double shot of whiskey so the hurting won't hurt so bad. Babe, I said, pour me a double shot of whiskey so the hurting won't hurt so bad. Pour me a double shot of whiskey so the hurting won't hurt so bad. And it's a long, long way to the liquor store, and I'm afraid she's gonna be mad. So pour me a double shot of whiskey so the hurting won't hurt so bad. Pour me a double shot. Walking to 7-Eleven, the man say what you need. He say you roll a duct tape and a case of nightmares. So give me a bottle of nightmares and rain full sleep my body needs. And jeans and vegan dentin with an antihistamine. Ladies and roll the piano, big day in the piano man. Dose. We gotta reach a till we keep the bathroom cabinet closed. So give me a bottle of nightmare and rain full sleep my body needs. And I'm jeans and gig and dead dead with an antihistamine. Yeah! junk. I don't know what they mean. I just can't be satisfied unless my tongue is green. So give me bottom like me. Faithful sleep, my body needs. And jeans and gig and dandy with an antihistamine. Have your brother Rick on guitar. Hey.
Thank you.
closed where I'm concerned, cause my dream is reality. Honey, I'm guilty of loving you with the first degree. Honey, I'm guilty in the first degree. Yes, I'm guilty. Don't set me free. I've been tried and convicted by your love and reality. Honey, I'm guilty of loving you in the first degree. Yes, I'm guilty of loving you in the first degree. You love always had trouble just to hound of my train. Started drinking doubles and I wound up in jail. I called my attorney about a quarter to five. He said, son, you never ever ought to drink when you drive. Listen, Mr. Lawyer, you gotta understand, when I'm a rock and roll honky tonk rambling man, I drive a big Cadillac and convertible car. I cash my unemployment and I hit for the bar. I order me a double with a pitcher of beer. I said, if that's my wife, Taylor Alvin ain't here. Every Friday night I get to play in the band. Then I'm a rock and roll honky tonk rambling man. Told me, son, you need to settle it down. Stop your honky-tonk and stop rambling round. I thank him very much for his encouraging words. I said, when I'm dead, you know he done what he could. I can't live forever, so I did what I can. But I'm a rock and roll honky-tonk rambling man. Just a hound of my train. I started drinking doubles and a wound up in jail. I called my attorney about a quarter to five. He said, son, you never ever ought to drink when you drive. Listen, Mr. Lawyer, you gotta understand, well, I'm a rock and roll honky-tonk rambling man.
I'd like to say we're awful glad to be here at the first reunion of the Armadillo. And I always enjoyed the many, many times that I played there. I played there probably close to 100 times with different people. I guess my most memorable show there was the first one I played with Graham Parsons and Emmylou Harris, all the way down to Bruce Springsteen and all kinds of people. But God bless you. Thank you. We'll be right back.
back in the 70s, Alvin Crow and the Pleasant Valley Boys, who were one of the hottest country bands in town, opened for a little rock and roll guy from New Jersey. Alvin, remember the night you came in, opened for Bruce Springsteen of the Armadillo for what, $1.95 cover? What was that like?
Well, it was fun. You know, very few people had ever heard of Bruce at the time. He was had kind of an underground following, had his first record out. And we normally we're getting $1 during the week in the Armadillo. And we had this big, long debate over whether we were overcharging by charging $1.50. And so we came out and opened on a Wednesday night for $1.50 for Bruce Springsteen. And I'd never heard of the guy before, and there's about 1,000 people showed up. So it was a lot of fun.
Those Bruce Springsteen shows were legendary. I think he did 3 of them at the Dillo before he got too famous and had to move to the bigger venue. How did the Dillo affect you and your music back in those days?
Well, it affected me a lot. It gave me a place to play, I guess. Gave me a chance to play with one of my first big heroes, which was Gram Parsons. About 1972 or so, right after I first got to Austin, I opened a show for Gram Parsons, and Emmylou Harris was a background singer for him, and it gave me a chance to actually play and be around people that I'd admired for a long time. So the Armadillo, you know, I started out playing there in 72 and went to 80, and it's been great for me.